the definite integrals of periodic functions. Definite integrals of periodic functions, right? We know what is a periodic function. In functions we discussed periodic function and their properties we know, right? Now come to today's topic. If f of x is a periodic function with period t, it is a periodic function whose period is t, then area under f of x for n periods would be n times the area under f of x for period 1, right? That is, integration of f of x from 0 to n pi n t is equal to n times, that is integration of f of x from 0 to t. It is the area of the curve for one period into n. If you do, you will get the total area of the function, that area from 0 to n t, right? Here t is the period of the function, right? For example, if you consider the graph of this periodic function, first f of x, let the period be, this is the period on x axis, suppose let it be x axis, okay, right? From 0, it is the periodic function whose graph, just to understand for the instant, it is a graph of some periodic function, right? It is 0 to t, it is 2t, 3t, and so on. It is nt, before that it is n minus 1 into t, right? Now we need to calculate the area of this periodic function, right? This is nothing but the area of the curve for one period. This is, these two gives you the area of the curve for two periods, right? And so on, the area of the curve for three periods, and so on, will get total as area of the curve for n periods, right? This is n periods. What the statement is, instead of counting all the areas from n t, we can multiply. So it is very clear, this is one, suppose it is a, area of the first one is a, suppose if you take area of this curve period a, this is again a, this is also a, and so on, it is a, and this is also a, right? Then this 0 to n t of f of x, integration of this is equal to n into integration of 0 to t f of x dx, right? So area of this one, what is give you a, and so on n times. Therefore, total area will give you n into area of that function. So what is the area? What is the area a gives you? That integration of 0 to t f of x dx, right? F of x dx. If you multiply with n, you will get the total area of the curve from 0 to n t, right? It is simple. So very clear, from the observation you can understand it, right? Now come to one example on this. Suppose the question is like this: integration of 0 to 2 pi modulus of let it be sin x dx, right? Now you need to understand this. What is the modulus, the graph of mod sin x? Graph of mod sin x. The sin x period is 2 pi, we know, right? It is the period 2 pi. Where it starts is, suppose it is pi by 2. Suppose it is y is equal to 1, right? It is the line y equal to 1. At pi by 2, sin pi by 2 is 1, we know. The graph of this is comes to 1 and then it is pi, right? And modulus, if you take modulus of this, for minus 1, the graph of this is minus 1. If you take, this is y equal to minus 1, the line, and this is a graph of sin x, right? It is pi by 2, pi, this is 3 pi by 2, this value is 3 pi by 2, and it is, that is 2 pi, right? Now we need to count the area of this curve between 0 to 2 pi, 0 to 2 pi of mod sin x. So mod sin x means the negative value of the sine curve will becomes positive again, right? That means this is the negative portion becomes positive now. So the graph becomes now, this is the negative portion of this becomes as positive. This is positive, right? Right. Now, what is the area we need to count? We need to count the area of this modulus of mod sin x. Area, it is the area we need to count, right? Fine. Now, instead of counting 0 to 2 pi, we need, it is sufficient to count the area from 0 to pi, right? Into 2, if you do, we will get the total area of this one, right? We know, and also we know that the area integration of 0 to pi by 2, 0 to pi by 2 sin x dx is, we know as 1, right? Its area is 1. We know how to calculate. Integration of sin x is minus cos x, minus cos x, the limits from is 0 to pi by 2, 0 to pi by 2. So we know that minus cos pi by 2, right, minus cos 0, cos 0, cos pi by 2 is 0, that is minus cos 0 is 1, so minus of minus 1 equal to 1, right? This is we know. That means integration of this, instead of writing this, we can find the area of 0 to pi by 2 into 4 you have to do, because look at the portion of this 0 to pi by 2, if you count, this is 4 times, because it is symmetric, 0 to pi by 2 area is same as pi by 2 to pi, and pi to 3 pi by 2, pi to 3 pi by 2, this area, right? There are symmetric portions which are 4 in 0 to 2 pi, this 0 to pi by 2, pi by 2 to pi, and pi to 3 pi by 2, and 3 pi by 2 to pi. Therefore, we need to calculate the area which is equal to 4 times of the area of the function in between 0 to pi by 2 of mod sin x, right? Mod sin x dx. We know its value is 1, its value is 1, we know. Therefore, it is 4 into 1 equal to 4. So, this is the area of this portion, right? This is the area of this portion. Therefore, 0 to n pi, nothing but it is n into 0 to pi, when if the period is pi by 2. Here, it is pi, and the area from 0 to pi, it is twice the area 0 to pi by 2. Therefore, you had total, there are 4 portions of 0 to pi by 2. Therefore, 4 into, we will get this, right? This is the one property of this periodic functions. Now, come to other one. The next one is integration of f of x from nt to nt is equal to n minus m integration of 0 to t f of x dx, right? Where m and n are integers, fine. it is also we can proceed similarly. So what you need to find the periodic function. We know the periodic function, right? Whose graph is, let it be, this is from 0 to t and t to 2t, right? And so on. It is up to mt, right? M into t and so on from nt. It is nt. Right, we need to calculate total area, right? So what you know is that we need to find the area of the portion from mt to area of this nt, right? This is the portion we need to calculate, right? Therefore what you do is we need to find the area from 0 to nt, right, minus area from 0 to mt, right? It is mt, m minus 1 into t, right? This is n minus 1 into t, fine. So what you know, to get the area of this, we need to find area from mt minus, right? Area from 0 to nt minus area from 0 to mt you need to do, right? Therefore, instead of this, that equal to what you can write? Right, total area integration of 0 to nt f of x dx minus 0 to nt mt f of x dx, right? So this value we know this is n into integration of 0 to t f of x dx minus, it is we know m into integration of 0 to t f of x dx, fine. Therefore from this you can take integration of 0 to t f of x dx, if you take it common, we'll get n minus m of integration of 0 to t f of x dx, right? This is the simple way we need to understand. Fine. It is the second property, and this, if you go for one example on this, find integration of, let it be integration of pi to 10 pi, right, mod cos x suppose dx. So it is simple that we know this integration of, that is 10 minus 1, if you apply the formula, this result, integration of 0 to pi mod cos x dx, right? Now, this is nothing but 9 into integration of 0 to pi modulus of cos x, right? So we need to find integration of modulus from 0 to pi. So come to the graph of the cos function. It is pi by 2 suppose, and it is pi, okay. From 1 it starts the graph, right, and here it approaches this, right. If you take the modulus, it is from 1 to this is minus 1, it is minus 1. Now, if you take the modulus, the negative part becomes positive, right? This becomes positive. This is positive. So, we need to find the area of this portion. What is the area? This area need to find it now. 0 to pi by 2 plus pi by 2 to pi. This is the area you need to find. And moreover, area between 0 to pi by 2 and pi by 2 to pi are same because it is symmetric, right? So it is sufficient that to find that 2 into integration of 0 to pi by 2, right? So it is cos x, it is sufficient to find 0 to pi by 2. whose value is 1 we know, right? This value is 1 into 2, that equal to 2. Fine. Therefore, we will get 9 into, his answer is 9 into, this area is 2, therefore 18. Right? This is the way we need to understand this formula. Now come to the other one. Next property, integration of a to a plus n t f of x dx equal to n into 0 to t f of x dx. That means a doesn't affect this result, right? Now how it is located? Now understand this graph. This is the periodic function whose period is t, right? Periodic function whose period is t. Now from where you are starting? From a comma 0 to a plus n t, right? From that you need to find the area. So what is the area you need to find? The area we need to calculate is from and this, either positive or negative, whatever that may be, this total area you need to calculate, right? Up to this portion we need to calculate. A to a plus n t, you need to calculate. Instead of that, look at here, this portion is same as this portion. You look at this portion, is same as the area of this portion here, area of this portion. That means if you take this part and make it fit here, that is fixes there, because both the areas are same and moreover it is symmetric. Fine. Therefore, it is sufficient to count that up to here, need to count up to n t. This is n t, this value is n t. This portion, this point is a plus n t, right? That is, from, it means that from a to a plus n t is same as from 0 to n t. That is where we know 0 to n t. That is integration of a to a plus n t f of x dx equal to 0 to n t f of x dx, right? But 0 to n t f of x dx, the first result if you apply, it is nothing but n into 0 to t f of x dx, right? 0 to n t f of x dx, right? This is the way you need to understand about the definite integration of periodic functions, okay? Thank you.